Hey, I'm Daniel, and on this episode of the Film Crazier Show, I was able to join in on a press day to speak with director and co-writer Takashi Shimizu for his new horror film, Howling Village. Takashi is a Japanese filmmaker known for writing and directing Ju-on, The Grudge, as well as the second film, and directing the American remakes The Grudge and The Grudge 2. His newest film, Howling Village, is about a psychologist who visits a haunted town known as Howling Village to investigate her brother's disappearance and uncover her family's dark history. I was able to talk to Takashi with the help of translator Ian McDougall, who also did the subtitles on the film. By the way, Howling Village is now playing in select theaters and is also available to rent on demand wherever you get your films, and will have a Blu-ray release date next month. Here is my first question. I'd love to ask, just the scene with the flooding phone booth. Were there some challenges with doing that scene, and was that a fun day on set?
その電話ボックスを、なんていう、水が入るときに、それはどうやって撮りました？それは、なんていう、撮りにくい、撮影しにくいシーンでしたか？なんていう、みんな楽しかったようなシーンでしたでしょうか？
ものすごく大変でした。真冬で、ただでさえ寒いときに、谷底に川が流れている橋のたもとで風がビュービュー吹いている冬の中で水に浸かる状態で俳優を入れなきゃいけなかったので、周りのスタッフも安全も気にしましたし、ずっと長く水につけていて本当に凍えて死んでしまうような寒さだったので、ワンショットだけ撮ったらすぐに出して暖かいところに連れてって、でまたワンショットだけ撮って暖かい車の中で待機してもらってとかっていうのを繰り返して、夕方準備して次の日の夜日が出る直前まで一晩中撮影してました。
It was a very difficult shot actually. It was done in midwinter. It was cold. It was windy. The staff, the production staff was freezing cold. They sort of take a shot and head for the car and leave the truck, get warm, come back, take another shot, head for the truck, and they just repeated this. They started one evening, basically it went into the next night to get it all in. So it was actually quite a difficult scene to get.
電話ボックスと同じ大きさの水槽を作ったので、水が抜けないように水槽を特別に作って撮影したんですけど、中には凍えないようにお湯を入れてたんですけど、それでもやっぱすぐ寒くなってしまうので、俳優の出し入れのたびに温めてあげて、しかも後からこう中に入れてるお湯の湯気が見えないように CG で消したりとか、結構大変なシーンではありました。
Yeah, they basically had a big water tank that they were pumping warm water into, but it was a very, very hard scene to shoot.
I'd love to ask, you've made so many horror films, so I'd be curious if there's any kind of horror story that you still want to tell, or any genre you still want to explore that you haven't explored yet.
Do you mean in horror or besides horror?
Oh, yeah, just in the horror genre, and if he wants other genres.
だからホラー映画、いろんなホラー映画を作ってきまして、なんていう、ホラーというジャンルの中には、他のやりたいの、まあ、あります、まだ。
ありますね、まだ。どうしても僕は、ジオンとかグラッジが最初の頃にあったので、ゴーストものは、こう求められがちなんですけど、他にもこれからも、ゾンビとかリビングデッドもやってみたいし、なんかホラーコメディとかもやってみたいですし、他にもやりたいことはあります。
So yes, actually, there are vast realms of horror genre that he hasn't touched yet. He would like to zombies. He hasn't touched zombies. He hasn't touched the living dead. And also, he has mentioned several times, actually, in various interviews tonight, he would like to do comedy. So if he can do a horror comedy, I think he's quite anxious to do as well.
I don't know if I have time for one more, but just I want to ask the song that Akina sings, the Be a Foul, Be a Bad, what inspired that creepy sort of nursery rhyme?
その秋田の歌ってるあのなんていうそういう子供を歌
はい、
はどっから来ました、どんなインスピレーション、
どっから来たか、あれは実は脚本を作っている途中で僕がふっと頭に湧いた言葉をポエムのように書き留めていて、それに曲を作
っていたもの。シナリオ
だから脚本シナリオオリジナルストーリーができる前に僕がいろいろな歴史の村を調べてバックグラウンドを作るために調べているときに思いついた言葉をいっぱい書き留めておいて、そこでできた歌詞に歌をつけて映画の中で使いたいと思って作った
んです。 As he was researching the looking, you know, looking at all other old villages and so on to sort of getTogether for this one, the elements of the poem came together as he was doing all that, and then basically it was a matter of putting music to it and then including it in the scenario.
だから実は日本語特有のダブルミーニングとかが入れてあったりする歌詞なので、英語圏の人にも分かるように。翻訳するのはすごく難しいあの歌詞になってます。
That was me. Yes, it was. He said there's a lot of double meaning in the Japanese lyrics and that the English getting the English lyrics to have those meanings was quite difficult. And I'm actually the guy who did the subtitles. So. Yes.
That was a problem.
Well, we sent a few messages back and forth.
Thanks for listening to this episode of the Film Crazy Show. And thanks again to Takashi Shimizu for the interview. And thanks to Ian McDougall for translating. If you like my interviews, please subscribe down below and stay tuned for more.